Holman started at college as he began to mark a significant moment in the life of our community. The entrusting of Star of Sea College, our presentation sister Victoria, stewardship of Kildare Ministries. This college and the land on which it stands have been places of nurturing and nourishment all gathered here across time. And so, if we acknowledge the traditional custodians of this land, the Wurundjeri people of the Kulin Nation. We acknowledge their deep spiritual connections to the land. We thank them for the care they have shown to the earth over thousands of years. We pay our respects to the elders, past, present and future, particularly in this reconciliation. In 1883, Star of the Sea College was begun by our presentation sisters, Mothers Paul Fay and John Byrne. It was born of the spirit of Nana Nagle, a spirit of hope and hospitality, care and compassion, inclusiveness and love, learning and love. Since then, Star of the Sea College has provided a holistic education for many generations of young women and has weathered challenges and change. Star flourished under the leadership and care of the presentation sisters and their co-workers, all of whom have embodied Jesus' mission of full and abundant life for all. In these days of Pentecost, we pray that the Spirit of the risen Lord may move with us and amongst us, and they recognized him in the breaking of the bread.
I have come that they may have life.
I have commissioned you to go out to bear fruit, fruit that will last.
I have come that you may have life.
Silver and gold I have none, but what I have I will give you.
I have come that you may have life.
In 2014, presentation sisters accepted the Wurundjeri sisters' invitation to partner with them in a new church. In accepting this invitation, we are enabling Star of the Sea College, Presentation Family Centre and Wellsprings for Women to continue in the spirit of Nana Nagle beyond the life of our congregation. And so, we gather today to entrust the past, present and unfolding future of Star of the Sea College to the trustees of Kildare Ministries.
We, the presentation sisters, come with mixed emotions to this moment as we hand over this precious ministry. We entrust all that surrounds and supports Star of the Sea College, its legacy and mission, into the safekeeping and stewardship of Kildare Ministries. While we feel a sense of loss and sadness that we, ourselves, are unable to continue this educational ministry here at Star, we are grateful that there are people of hope and vision who share Jesus' dream of fullness of life for all. These are the ones who will take Star into the future. I now invite presentation sisters to stand together as we proclaim our gift of Star of the Sea College.
Faith and confidence, we, presentation sisters of Victoria, entrust Star of the Sea College and all that surrounds and supports its mission of fullness of life for all to the stewardship of Kildare Ministries Trustees. We will continue to accompany the Kildare Ministries Trustees and the Star of Sea College community in spirit, one with you in presentation, heart and story, one with you in faith and love.
We symbolically mark this moment by inviting Rosemary Copeland, co-chair of Kildare Ministries Trustees, to accept this plaque on behalf of the trustees. The plaque signifies the changing role of the presentation sisters here at the Star, from one of responsibility and governance to that of accompaniment in prayer and blessing.
I want to
big, big thank you has to go to the presentation assistants. It's, you know, all those years ago, it was presentation assistants who came here and made a decision that Catholic education in the spirit of man and women had to be provided together. And so they did for generation after generation, seeing enormous change, both social and educational over that time, going from a rate increase in lay staff to eventually, of course, lay principals to incorporation of the board, all as a part of their care and love for this school. I would say that this decision of the presentation assistants to hand over the school to Kildare Ministries at this point in time probably equates to the courage of those original women who came here and has decided to establish this school in the spirit of story with Nan and Mabel. They have cared for the school with such love and such commitment and such selflessness. I think this decision now to hand over is born of that absolute selflessness. I'm sure it involves pain and angst for them as well. I think it's an incredibly courageous decision. And it's a decision based in their absolutely firm desire to ensure that that original mission to educate young women in a Catholic context within the spirit and story of Nan and Mabel will continue on indefinitely. So to the presentation sisters, such a deep thank you. And over, of course, to Kildare Ministries, I can say it is with great optimism that we look forward to not only continuing the vision of Nano, but to experience the emerging of the Kildare Ministries. The Kildare Ministries story, which will run alongside the Nan and Mabel story. So thank you to all of you for being here.